Day of Victory.
Hi, honey.
Morning. Hello. Good morning. Call to worship, Psalm 24:7-10. Lift up your heads, you gates. Be lifted up, you ancient doors, that the King of Glory may come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, you gates. Lift them up, you ancient doors, that the King of Glory may come in. Who is he, this King of Glory? The Lord Almighty, he is the King of Glory.
Amen. Music team.
You stand right here.
Kids, am I right?
Oh dear.
Okay. Yep, we'll do music.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Fair enough.
Hello. There we are. Yeah. Yeah, you got shade. Okay, we got. Yeah. We're good.
We're all good.
Yeah. Please stand.
Okay. That's okay.
It's okay.
Shall we?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Yeah, go.
We have a story of grace. We have an anthem of hope. We have a reason to praise. We are redeemed and restored. You are the great liberator. You ransomed us from our shame. Now by the blood of the Savior, everything broken will change. Oh, this will be my day of victory. My chains are gone. Now I am free indeed. Every turn is great, amazing grace. Oh, the rest is to celebrate your love. Press one. I'm free indeed, my jubilee has come. No longer slaves of the past, this is the year of the Lord. Here at the foot of the cross, we are outside it no more. Made a way through the darkness into your marvelous light. You broke the bondage and held us. Now we are fully alive. Oh, this will be my day of victory. My chains are gone. Now I am. Every turn is made by amazing grace. All I plans is to celebrate your love. As one, I'm free indeed, my jubilee has come. my prison. You brought me back from the grave. You turned my mourning to dancing. Into the night I proclaim. Let this will be our day of victory. Our chains are gone. Now we are free indeed. For this will be our day of victory. Our chains are gone. Now we are free indeed. Every man is saved by amazing grace. Oh, that blessed we celebrate your love. As one, we're free indeed. As you love me, have come.
Well done, and thanks, Darren. Please be seated.
The smallest seeds make the tallest trees. The unwanted can belong. And the act of love that made this life was an act of sacrifice by a man of light who split the night and paid the highest price. So those in pain could rise again and make a fresh new start. And that's the point of Easter you may wish to take to heart.
Well, good morning, everyone, and a very special welcome. If you're a guest, if you're the first time, you are extremely welcome to our service today. This is Palm Sunday, which begins Holy Week, the week where we remember those events of Jesus' final week on earth. So we'll be going through today with scripture passages and also three quizzes, would you believe, to help us remember the story. So if you have an insert in your bulletin, please take that out and throw it away, because we don't want you to see the back of that insert for the quizzes. Okay, so do not look at it. Put it at the down under your table now. And I know you are honest. If you have an insert, take it out and don't look at it until later. Well, let us begin our story with a wonderful celebration, Palm Sunday. And I would like to invite Abby and Zoe to read that story for us. And I think you can use this microphone. Is that the best idea? Thank you, girls. Maybe the one who's not reading, hold the microphone and then pass it to the one when you change. Is that a good idea?
You hold and get up to hear while she's reading.
Close. Okay, that's better. Close to your mouth. Nice and close to your mouth.
As they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethpage and Bethany at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you, and just as you enter it, you will find a cot tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Why are you doing this?' say, 'The Lord needs it and will send it back here shortly.'" They went and found a colt outside in the street, tied at the doorway. As they untied it, some people standing there asked, "What are you doing untying the colt?"
They answered as Jesus had told them to, and the people let them go. When they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their cloaks over it, he sat on it. Many people spread their cloaks on the road, while others spread branches they had cut in the fields. Those who went ahead and those who followed shouted, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David. Hosanna in the highest heaven."
Thank you, girls. Let's give them a big hand. Great job. Really careful of that. Okay, we're going to have a song now to express that celebratory spirit when Jesus arrived in Jerusalem on Palm Sunday. Thanks.
So we thought we'd would make it a little bit interactive. So you've all had a great time with the instruments, and keep it up throughout the service. We really like making a joyful noise to our Lord. So we're going. So if you can stand, and we're doing a song that the children have learnt in Sunday school. It's pretty pretty interactive, but we'll just run through it once for you, just so that you get the idea, and then we'll run through it a few more times.
Please stand.
Please stand. Okay, yeah.
Can we just
stop playing?
Yeah, just once. Hallelujah, 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 praise the Lord.
That's great. It looks like you've all gotten used to it. So what we're going to do is make it a little bit faster each time. So we'll do it another three times. Thanks, Darren. And just to keep you awake and make sure I know that, see who has had their coffee or not this morning, every time you sing hallelujah or hallelujah, you sit down.
Okay.
And every time you sing praise the Lord, you stand up.
You can squat.
This is good. Squatting is really good for your thighs. So as long as you do it right, right?
Well done. Well, Jesus arrived with great celebration, but then was in. Oh, where are we? I'll just make sure I get the right. Yes. Oh, he had the Last Supper. So we have a quiz on the Last Supper. So just do that together in your groups, and you know you cannot look up the Bible. So you just doesn't matter if you're wrong. This is a learning experience for you. So while we do that, we'll quietly listen to a nice song. And then, as I say, the answers will be at the end of the service, hopefully.
He became sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah. blessing from heaven. Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. His body the bread, his blood the wine, broken and poured out, all for love. The whole earth trembled and the veil was torn. Love so amazing. Love so amazing, yeah. Jesus Messiah, name above all. Blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. All our hope is in you. All our hope is in you. All the glory to you, God, the light of the world. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven. Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. Jesus Messiah, Lord of all.
Well done, well done. The Skype team's finished. Okay, everyone, thank you. I know you haven't, some of you haven't finished. This team has, by the way, let it be known. So next time you do it, you know what to do. What I suggest is you get one person to read out the question and then you can discuss it. Sorry, I should have said that before. I saw one group who were all stoically sitting around reading like they were reading the Sunday paper. Sorry. No. So next time, one person read and the rest of you can discuss the answer. Okay? Great. Now, this is time now where we have communion because we are celebrating the Last Supper of Jesus. And that is when he instituted this special feast, if you like, that we have. Now, the purpose of communion is to remind us of Jesus' body that was broken on the cross, and his blood that was poured out for the forgiveness of sins. A very simple thing, a bit of bread and a little bit of juice or wine or whatever, just to remind us of the central story. Easter comes once a year, but the impact of this is all through the year, and we remember it in our church on the first Sunday of every month. So everyone is welcome to participate in communion. We especially invite those who are Christians who believe in Jesus. If you're not sure about all that, and I would say feel free just to not worry about grabbing the juice. If you want to, that is fine too. But this is our practice for those who say, yes, I believe that Jesus took the punishment for me and forgave my sins. So I'd like to invite the two elders that are on today. I never know who they are, but the great thing is, even if you don't, some people stand up. So Sulan's one of them, and Tony, that'll do. That'll be great. Don't worry, I always forget to look at that roster too. We have a number of elders in our church, and this is not the time to make them stand up, but another time. Okay, if you could help me. Tony, if you could just help me take that one off. So on the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread. It would have looked nothing like this, but it was bread nonetheless. And he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Eat this bread in memory of me." In the same way, he took the cup and said, "This cup is the blood of the new covenant. I will not drink it again until I drink the fruit of the vine in the kingdom of God. And it is poured out for the forgiveness of sins." And then Paul the apostle adds later, "Whenever you eat this bread and drink this wine, you proclaim, you tell the world, until Jesus comes, what has occurred." And we proclaim Jesus. So we'll pass these around, and I invite you to take one, and we'll have them together when I say. Great. If it's getting a bit low, don't worry. Someone will find more. Probably Jean. or Suan. No, she's a bit busy. Everyone got one that wants one? Just put up your hand if you haven't. Wonderful. We need about three up here. Yes, well, here we are. Roughly three. Thank you, Sulan. Here we are. You are welcome to have two each if there's spare. Okay. So just tear up the little plastic bit first. Here we are. The top one. And there's a little bit of wafer put down on your tongue. And it should sort of dissolve over the next few seconds. And you can chew it. Stuck to the roof of my mouth. And then just tear the foil. Yes, it is still stuck to the roof of my mouth if you wonder. But it will eventually disappear. The blood of Christ. Let us pray. Father, thank you for sending your Son, Jesus, to die for us. Thank you that we celebrate and remember that incredible sacrifice as we take the bread and we take the wine. Thank you. We love you. We worship you. In your Son's name, amen. Thank you so much, guys. We'll just come back. I would now like to invite Jackie, Eva's daughter, to come and read for us the next passage. So Jesus has had the Last Supper with his disciples, and now he has gone to the garden, Gethsemane, to pray. And just stand up there if you want.
Today's reading is from Gethsemane, Mark 14, 32 to 46. And it's on the third and fourth page in your booklets. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John along with him, and he began to be deeply distressed and troubled. "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death," he said to them. "Stay here and keep watch." Going a little farther, he fell to the ground and prayed that, if possible, the hour might pass from him. "Abba, Father," he said, "everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Simon," he said to Peter, "are you asleep? Couldn't you keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Once more, he went away and prayed the same thing. When he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. They did not know what to say to him. Returning the third time, he said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Enough! The hour has come. Look, the Son of Man is delivered into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer." Just as he was speaking, Judas, one of the 12, appeared. With him was a crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the elders. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. "The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard." Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Rabbi," and kissed him. The men seized Jesus and arrested him. Thank you for...
Thanks, Jackie. That's great. Okay, I'll invite Benson up to pray for the suffering. Thank you, Benson. Oh, that's fine. Yep, you can use your phone. Awesome.
Good Friday prayer for those who suffer. Jesus, you walked a dark path. You took on the suffering of the world as your own. And so today we pray for all those who suffer. We see your face in the face of those in captivity. And so we pray for inmates in Mount Eden prison, whose pain is muffled by high walls and barbed wire. We see your face in the face of those unjustly accused. And so we pray for those who are being held without a trial, who fear they will not get out alive. We see your face in those who are tortured. And so we pray for all who are chained and whose bodies flinch with every blow. We see your face in all who are condemned to death. And so we pray for those who are in our world who are awaiting execution. We see your face in all who are dying. And so we pray for all who are taking their last breath today. On this day of sorrow, we journey with you. Thank you for suffering with us and for us. You know the torment of rejection and the pain that our frail human bodies can endure. Thank you that you are with us, this sorry world, as we wait for a resurrection. Amen.
Amen. Right, we have our second quiz, which is on the trial. And so you know what to do now, don't you? Now, can I say, if you do not know the answer, that is totally fine. This is a learning opportunity for you. So just put whatever you think, and then you'll find out later. Thanks.
Shadows deep But do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through? Do you wish that you could see it all made?
His whole creation groaning. There's a new creation coming. There's the glory of the Lord to be the night within our midst. Is it good that we remind ourselves of this?
Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and bend the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he's David's ruler, and the Lamb who died to cleanse from the slave.
Is he worthy? Is he worthy of all blessing and honor and glory? Is he worthy of this? As the God true love us,
he
does the Spirit move among us,
he
and does Jesus our Messiah hold forever those he loves,
he
does our God intend to dwell again with us.
He does. Is anyone worthy? Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he has saved his life.
I'll invite the musicians up. Thank you. I don't know about you, but some of those questions were hard. If you didn't know the answer, that's fine. You will.
Right, everyone, please stand.
Right.
Man of Sorrows.
Man of Sorrows, Lamb of God, by his own betrayed, the sin of man and wrath of God has been on Jesus laid. Silent as he stood accused, beaten, mocked, and scorned, bowing to the Father's will, he took a crown of thorns. On the rugged cross, my salvation, love poured out to love me. Now my soul cries out, Alleluia, praise and honor unto thee.
In heaven.
Sent from heaven, God's own Son, to purchase and redeem. Reconcile the very ones who nailed him to that tree. On that rugged cross, my salvation, where your love poured out over me. Now my soul cries out, Alleluia, praise and honor unto thee.
Now my debt
is paid, it is paid in full by the precious blood that my Jesus spilled. Now the curse of sin has no hold on me. Through the sun sets free, oh, is free indeed. Now my debt is paid, it is paid in full by the precious blood that my Jesus spilled. Now the curse of sin has no hold on me. Through the sun sets free, oh, is free indeed. My salvation, where your love poured out over me. Now my soul cries out, Alleluia, praise and honor unto me. See, the stone is rolled away. Behold the empty tomb. Alleluia, God be praised. He's risen from the grave. All that rugged cross, my salvation, where your love poured out over me.
Please be seated. I invite Lillian now to read the death of Christ. I think it is Good Friday. Thank you.
The next reading is from Mark chapter 15, verse 21 to 32. That's on your page 5 up in the booklets. A certain man from Cyrene, Simon, the father of Alexander and Rufus, was passing by on his way in from the country, and they forced him to carry the cross. They brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. Then they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him. Dividing up his clothes, they cast lots to see what each would get. It was 9 in the morning when they crucified him. The written notice of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." They crucified 2 rebels with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by hurled insult at him, shaking their heads and saying, "So, you who are going to destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, come down from the cross and save yourself." In the same way, the chief priests and the teachers of the law mocked him among themselves. "He saved others," they said, "but he can't save himself. So let this Messiah, this King of Israel, come down now from the cross, that we may see and believe." Those crucified with him also heaped insults on him. May the Lord be with you.
Let us stand to sing "Above All." Please be seated. Final quiz this morning, the death of Jesus. So you've got 5 minutes to do this together, so go for it.
Our transgressions upon him.
upon him. Christ has died, we are forgiven, and Christ alive. We are the risen, and he shall come again. Praise the King, praise the King. Upon our hearts, his name is written, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We're pouring out a song of praise together. Upon him, upon him. Christ has died, we are forgiven, and Christ alive. We are the risen, and he shall come again. Praise the King, praise the King. Christ has died, we are forgiven. We are the risen, and we shall come again. Praise the King, praise the King. One name upon our lips, Jesus. No greater name than this, Jesus. And every knee will bow, every heart will.
I don't know about you, but I found that slightly easier than the second one. Yes, look.
We are the risen, and
yeah, exactly. So you are allowed now to look at the answers, and if you need answers, then they can be handed to you. As long as you concentrate on what I'm saying. Okay, thanks, guys. Okay. The bell rings. Thank you for the bell. Keep that bell ringing, by the way. That's good. The bell rings and dinner is served. Who's got a bell? You want to ring that bell? Yes, thank you. Dinner is served. As everyone takes a seat, the experts make an appearance, and they have one mission. Cause hell. Anyone know what I'm talking about? I'll leave you out of suspense. Married at First Sight Australia, the TV show, which I'm sure not many of us are following, maybe some of you. So the experts put a bunch of what they call sledge boxes on the table, and then they run back to their room with their TV screens to watch the mayhem that ensues. What is a sledge box? It is a box filled with questions designed to get people into fights, to insult one another. There is only one. There is one small problem with the sledge box in the final dinner of Australia Married at First Sight. What is the problem? Are there any insults left after a whole TV series? They've been insulting each other for weeks. Well, maybe there's a few. We are talking about reality TV here. And what's the thing about reality TV? It's not reality, but it is TV. But I think it gives us an insight into human nature. For those that can actually bear to watch the show. One of the biggest insights, human beings are selfish. When we look at relationships with others, the question we so often ask is, what can I get out of it? How can I get my needs met? How can I win? Now extrapolate that or extend that out to colleagues, communities, and countries. And I can tell you, this is not a recipe for peace and harmony in our world, is it? The Bible is full of practical wisdom to help us in relationships. For example, everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak. It's coming, thank you, Darren. And slow to become angry. Thank you, Darren. Here's another. Do not judge, or you too will be judged. First take the plank, thank you, Darren, out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother or sister's eye. And another, do to others as you would have them do to you. Great advice. Maybe if the math contestants followed that piece of wisdom, some of them might stay married. But then probably people wouldn't watch it, would they? Because we love the scintillating and the scandalous. Because in our heart of hearts, we kind of like bad stuff sometimes more than good stuff. We like to do naughty things rather than nice things. The Bible calls this sin. Sin is basically selfishness. Our motto could be described as, let's make me great again. The idea of sin is not very popular these days. We prefer to, and here's a big word, pathologize our situation. What does that mean? We think we need treatment rather than judgment. We are victims and not sinners. I don't care what you call it, but something is wrong with this world. And I don't see modern medicine or technology really improving it a whole lot. English writer and philosopher G.K. Chesterton once wrote in the letters to the editor, "Dear Sir, regarding your article, What's Wrong with the World? I am. Yours truly, G.K. Chesterton. What's wrong with the world? I am. And so are you." And nothing less than a spiritual transformation will make things right. And that is where Easter comes in. When Jesus died on the cross on Good Friday, approximately 1,990 years ago, he broke something and he fixed something. He broke the power of our sinful, selfish attitudes and the death that was the inevitable result. And he fixed our relationship with God, with ourselves, with other people, and with the world that we were meant to care for. Then God confirmed the success of Jesus' mission on Easter Sunday by raising him from the dead. But you may say, look around. The world is still in a mess, isn't it? Yes, but God has provided the answer. And he invites us to accept his invitation. Come to me, all who are weary, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke, my burden upon you, and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart. And you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. What is rest? Peace. Shalom. right relationship with God, with ourselves, with other people, and the world that we were made to care for. Easter Sunday reminds us that one day the striving and suffering of humanity and the whole world will end. Friday's good. We had our Kiwi Talk yesterday, and one of the guys on my table said, "Why is it called Good Friday?" Here's the answer. Friday's good because Sunday's coming. Don't lose hope because Sunday's coming. Thank you, music team. And straight after that, I'll invite Benson to read and then our final song. So we're almost there. Well done. Slightly over, but it was a very ambitious program, wasn't it? Let's be honest. Thanks.
Let's stand. Here we go. Please be seated. Benson.
Good morning. Today's final Bible reading is from for Easter Sunday, is from Mark chapter 16, Palm Sunday. Mark chapter 16, verses 1 to 8. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that it may go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other, "Who will roll away the stone from the entrance of the tomb?" But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. "Don't be alarmed," he said. "You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. see the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter, he is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." Trembling and bewildered, the women went out and fled from the tomb. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid. May God bless us with understanding of his holy word. Amen.
Thanks so much, Benson. He also took over Rob Wong's place, so thanks so much. Okay, we want you all to stand. We want, if you've got anything to make a noise, make a big noise. This is our final celebratory song. Feel free just to really let us have it. Thanks. Well done, everyone. Stay standing. Thank you so much. I'd like everyone to give, especially the kids, a very big clap for their involvement today. That's a big, long service to stay through, and you were amazing. And Charlotte was particularly amazing. And but you were all great. So on the back of your answers, you'll see a Good Friday march that there's an opportunity for you to do. So what you do is you go around various parts of the city and read the story of Jesus, and there's a prayer, and it's different churches in Auckland. And so I'm just wanting an indication from you if you might be interested. If there's sort of at least half a dozen, then they will probably give us one of the readings. So can I just get an indication if you would like from, is it 9 a.m. start at Albert Park? 9 a.m. at Albert Park on Good Friday for that Good Friday march. Just raise your hand if you're not, that's fine. Thank you, Suanse. Very good. She goes every year. That's great. Thank you. We probably won't volunteer for a reading in that case, but do feel free to go. Speaking of going, don't rush off because we have morning tea. So I'm going to bless you and we'll get into it. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, every single one of us, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. God bless.